And in the last class, we had started a basic concept of equation and identities, right? And I had given you a list of formula of algebra so that we could start our chapter easily. And I think we had reached up to 6, I guess. And now still 2 formulas are left. Now we will complete that. And from today onwards, we'll start our exercise officially, right? And good news for you as well. You'll have assignments also, right? So let me take you to the whiteboard, okay? Because our subject is maths, so I can't do this with only video, right? I should show you the board as well. So now we are continuing our mathematics, okay? I think you should write it in copy, right? Make a separate copy for optional mathematics and continue the formula. Now it is number 7. I think up to 6, I had written the formulas in next class, right? Previous class. Let's resume it from 7. And our second last formula is a cube plus b cube. Is it clear? It is very much important formula. And its expansion goes like this. A plus b. And the next expression will be a square minus ab plus b square. Is it clear to everyone? I think it is clear. Right? A cube plus b cube expands like this. A plus b, a square minus ab plus b square. And now you might wonder, from where did it come? You can multiply these two. And you'll end up getting this one as result. Right? So to prove this, you can multiply these two expressions from RHS. And you will immediately get the left hand side, right? And this one has next formula as well. It is a cube plus b cube. And it goes like this. A plus b whole cube minus 3ab a plus b. This one. And as of now, we need this one primarily. Is it clear? The second one is a bit less important. And first one is very much important, right? This is much important than second one. And likewise, same rule is applied for a cube minus b cube as well. It follows the same pattern. Look here. A minus b, a square plus ab plus b square. Just copy for now, and I'll explain you later. A cube minus b cube. The next formula is a minus b whole cube plus 3ab a minus b. And I like to request you all, be very much careful in the sign convention, right? There are signs as well. You should be careful about it. So look here again. There is plus sign between a cube and b cube. So we start with plus in first expression, right? And in the second one, we have used negative as first sign and positive as last sign. So if there is positive, even the first expression will contain positive sign. And the second expression will use negative sign as the first one. And look at here. Here is negative one at first. So this first expression will take negative as first sign. And the second one will begin with positive as first sign. So it follows the pattern like this. Plus, plus, and minus. The end one will be always plus. Here is also the similar pattern. Minus, minus, and plus. The end one is always positive. So these two formula are very much important and very much confusing for the beginners. So be careful about it. And now you might be wondering about the second one. Where did it came from? And same followed by this, right? So let me explain you. In the previous lecture, I had written a formula. Let me remind you. It was a plus b whole cube gives. This is just rough, right? This is not to be written in a note. Or you can write it in the rough. The formula was a cube plus b cube plus 3ab and a plus b. You remember it, right? This was our formula. The next one, second one. If you take these two at one side and this part in the left, look what it happens. A plus b whole cube minus 3ab and a plus b. This will give a cube plus b cube. Let me explain you further. Look here, this was our previous formula, right? And I have kept it in the right without touching it. Is it clear? And this expression has been shifted to left part. So this sign becomes minus over here, right? And this remains at the right part. And this will be our final formula. And same has been written over here. Look here, this is the same, right? These two are same, I think. AQ plus BQ gives A plus B whole cube minus 3AB A plus B. I think this is the same one. Look at here. I have just arranged that formula and written over here. And same is followed for this one as well, right? Is it clear now? So you need to write this four formula in your note. And as of now, you should memorize this first and this one. You don't need four at once, just you can read two for now. Is it clear, everyone? And these topics are to be studied in compulsory maths, right? But these are also important for optional mathematics as well. So I have revised you. Is it clear? Now we'll start our exercise officially, and it will be 6.1 trigonometrical identities. I want you to write the heading. Let me rub it, right? Let me rub it. Now open your copy and write heading 6.1 trigonometrical identities. And be ready for your assignments as well, right? You are desperately waiting for assignments, as I guess. Now let's begin. The first number is calculate the product. Calculate the product. Calculate the product. And let me inform you first, in this exercise, we are just trying to learn how to use the trigonometrical identities as you use it in algebra. See mathematics, right? We are trying to transform our knowledge of compulsory math into optional mathematics. So the questions will be very simple, but look it carefully. If you don't pay attention over here, you will cry in next exercise. So be careful. The first question goes like this. Look at here. We are asked to calculate product, right? 1 minus cosec theta and 1 plus cosec theta plus cosec square theta. Is it clear? Let me show you. 1 minus cosec theta, one expression. And the next one is 1 plus cosec theta plus cosec square theta. Now it says to calculate the product. And there are two ways of doing it. Either you can directly multiply this one, or it is better to use formula. Let me show you how to use the formula over here. Just compare this with standard formula we have written just minutes ago. Look at here. It is similar like A minus B. And it is like A square plus AB plus B square. Now you might tell how. Look at here. Let us suppose A is 1. And cosec theta is B. So what will be A square? A square will be 1 square, which is 1. And A square is 1. It is true, right? And AB means 1 into cosec theta. It will be cosec theta. So AB means cosec theta. It is also true over here. And the last one is B square or cosec square. So here is cosec square given. So this means this is exactly as per pattern of the formula, right? Now you have understood, I guess, okay, this is the formula of A cube minus B cube. Did you get it? This is the formula of A cube minus B cube. So it will be directly, it will be A cube, A is 1 over here, and B cube will be cosec theta whole cube. Is it clear? A cube minus B cube. Look at here, A minus B, A square means 1 square is 1, plus AB plus B square. If you are still at doubt, I will make it a bit simplified. Look at here. It will be A minus B, A minus B, and A square plus AB, AB plus B square. Now it is simple. Look at here. A minus B, exactly the same. A square, 1 square is 1. AB, 1 into cosec is cosec, and B square. Cosec theta whole square means cosec square theta, right? And it will be directly transformed into this one. This is our standard formula, which we had just written few minutes back, right? A cube minus B cube. Now, finally, it will be 1 cube results 1, and minus is minus as it is. and cosec theta whole cube becomes cosec cubed theta, cosec cubed theta, right? And this is our final answer. And this is very much simple, right? These sorts of question won't be asked in exam, but this will be used in the middle steps of longer questions, right? This is clear, right? Can I rub it? Someone raise hand. Raise your hand if you have copied this. Have you copied this? So thank you for that. Thank you for your gesture. Let me go to the second one, okay? Let us do second one. Now, the second question is like this. B, it says 5 tan theta minus 3 cos theta, and this should be multiplied with 7 tan theta minus cos theta. This is the one. And this is also very easy. You have already done this in CMath, right? Here used to be x and here used to be y. Now here is tan and cos. Now let me start, right? Now this, I think this is not arranged in any kind of pattern. Look over here. This does not fit to any formula. So we have only one method to multiply it directly. So it goes like this. Okay, first one is 5 tan theta. Let us multiply this first. This multiplies to this. And then in second one, this multiplies to this one. Right? This is y, 5 tan theta. And in the next step is the turn of 3 cos theta. It will firstly multiply to this one and secondly to this one. This is did too same to that of C mathematics, right? So let us continue. It seems like this, 5 tan theta, it will multiply directly to 7 tan theta minus cos theta. I'm using very much simple steps for you. After you will be a bit expert, then we'll jump the simple steps, right? And it is again 7 tan theta minus cos theta. Is it clear? First of all, what we do? We multiply this one totally by 5 tan theta. And then this minus 3 cos theta is over here. And this multiplies this bracketed one expression further. Is it clear? Now let us open this one. 5 7 is 35, which is very easy. 35 and tan theta multiplied by tan theta becomes tan square theta, or you can write it tan theta whole square, right? And then 5 1 is 5 and tan into cos becomes tan dot cos. Tan dot cos. Is it clear? Now the next one, minus over here. Minus is here. 3 7 is 21. Cos and tan. It becomes cos and tan. Right, and the next one is minus minus becomes plus. Is it clear? And I think I should write it to the next line. Minus minus becomes plus, and 3 is 3 over here, and cos multiplied by cos will be cos square theta. Right, let me repeat it to you. First one is, look over here, 5 7 is 35 and tan square theta, tan tan square. Right, second one is 5 1 is 5 and minus is minus over here, right? And tan and cos becomes tan cos. It can't be directly multiplied. And look over here, minus and plus becomes minus. 3 7s are 21. Cos and tan becomes cos and tan over here. No change. And the last one is minus and minus multiplied. It makes plus, right? And cos becomes cos square. Is it clear? It is very easy. Like that of your normal algebra. Is it clear? Now, I think we can solve it further. Look over here. It will be now 35 tan square theta. It is as it is. But I think these two can be added. Look over here. Just a second. I think you can do this one, right? AB plus 3BA. Its result will be 4AB, right? Because AB and BA means same in algebra. Is it clear? And this is the similar case, I think. Look over here. Tan and cos is here. And here it is cos and tan. So tan cos and cos tan means same. Because these are under multiplication. So we can write minus 5 minus 21 means minus 26, I guess, right? It is minus 26. And tan cos is similar. Tan theta cos theta is the
next expression, and then it is followed by plus 3 cos square theta at the end, right? What we have done is we have just multiplied this to one. Look over here, we have multiplied this one. Tan cos is tan cos multiplication, and this cos tan is also under multiplication, so we have converted this 2 into tan cos, right? And we have added this minus 5 and minus 21 to result minus 26, right? And this 3 cos square over the end is at the end, as it is, right? Now we have 3 terms over here. Is it clear? This could be the answer. This could be the answer, but I think this is not the answer again. Why? Because we can solve it further. Look over here, 3 5 35, tan square theta can't be changed further. But here, you can write 26. Tan theta means what? It is sine theta by cos theta, right? Tan theta means sine by cos. We have already discussed this in our last class, right? And this cos is remaining one. Look over here. I have made this tan as sine by cos, right? And the second cos is as it is. Now the last one, 3 cos square theta. This is unchanged. Now what we can do further is you can cancel this 2-1. Right, it is now more simplified. Now finally it will end like this: 35 tan square theta minus 26 sine theta plus 3 cos square theta. This will be our final answer. Is it clear? Should I repeat this? It was very easy. We had just followed a simple multiplication pattern of algebra, right? Then we added these two. And then we had converted tan into sine by cos, and we cancelled the cos, right? This is our answer, final answer. Is it clear? And if you had left your answer over here in this step, even this is the correct one. This is not the wrong, but this will be incomplete. Is it clear? So this question is very much easy, right? You can even leave your question in this step, but this will not be that good. This is better one. Right, and in this step, I have done tan as sine by cos. Sine by cos ratio gives tan, right? And this cos is over here, and we have cancelled the two cos. Is it clear? This was very easy. Can I rub it? Raise your hand if I can rub it. Nobody's raising hand. Thank you for your gesture. Now let me rub it. This was very easy, right? Because we always begin from simpler ones. And after some day, you will be shocked to see the questions. The questions will get harder and harder day by day. So I want you to practice adequately. Is it clear? Now, let us move to the second one, right, number 2. And it says factorize. It says to factorize. And this factorization is also very much similar to that of algebra of C mathematics. This is also very easy. Now let us move to the first question. It says factorize cos co power 6 theta minus sine raised to the power 6 theta. Is it clear? Cos 6 theta, it is power, right? You cannot write this as this. This is wrong representation, right? We have written it as a power, not coefficient. Is it clear? This was not our actual representation. Our actual representation is this. Is it clear up to now? So this is a direct formula. Look over here. Cos 6 theta can be written as cos theta raised to the power 6. Is it clear? And this can be written as sine theta raised to the power 6. Right? And do you have formula for A6 minus B6 term? We don't have. We have only AQ minus BQ, or you have A square minus B square. So this is wiser to break it as cos square theta cubed. Is it clear? And even here, sine square theta cubed. Why is it so? Because 2 and 3 multiplied becomes 6. And 2 and 3 multiplied becomes 6. So this is very simple. Why have we done this? To change into the standard formula, because we don't have formula for A6 minus B6 directly. So we are firstly transforming it into a cube minus b cube form. Now we will use the formula. Now, few minutes back, I had given you a formula, right? It was a cube minus b cube. What was the formula? A minus b, right? A square plus ab plus b square. Do you remember this? This is very easy, right? So let us convert this one to that form. Now, I know you might be wondering, sir, why we have done this and not this. Look at here. You could also have done this, right? You could have done this as well. You might be wondering, right? Okay, we have done here 2, 3, 6. But you could also have done 3 and 2. Even this is correct. Here we will use a square minus b square. Here we will use a cube minus b cube. Both are correct. None is wrong. Right? Both one are correct. Is it clear? So I will solve this by both methods. Right? Because we are not given here to prove anything. We just have to factorize. You can factorize in your own way. Right? So let us solve this first. A cube minus b cube. And let me inform you, okay, this is our a. This cos square theta is our a, right? And this sine square theta is our b. So it will be a cube minus b cube, right? So our exact formula will be, look at here, it will be firstly a minus b, a minus b, a minus b, right? Because our a is cos square, b is sine square. So a minus b will look like this, a square minus b square. And the next expression will be a square means a square, right? Plus ab, plus a, b, plus ab, right? And the last one will be plus b square, plus b square. I think I should repeat this one. Let me repeat it, right? The first one is, look over here. This is a cube minus b cube. What is a? The quantity inside green circle is a. And the quantity inside next green circle is b. So a minus b will be a minus b. Is it clear? And in the next one, here is a whole square minus a b plus b whole square. Is it clear? This is ditto same to the form like this. Look at here. A minus b, a square, a b, b square. And this is similar to this one. A minus b, a square, a b, b square. Is it clear? This is clear, right? Now we can solve it further. So this will be solved as, look at here, cos square theta and sine square theta. This can be written as it is. Right? But this one, look at here. Cos square theta whole square makes it cos 4 theta. Why? Because 2 into 2 becomes 4. Right? Power and power can be multiplied. I think we have studied this in law of indices, right? And the next one is cos square theta sine square theta. Is it clear? And the last one will be sine 4 theta. This is power, okay? This is power, not the coefficient. This is power. So this will be our final expression. You can further solve this. You can again change this cos 4 and sine 4 into a 4 plus b 4 form, but this is not necessary as of now. Right? We can again further solve this, but leaving at this step does not make any problem. Is it clear? So this one is factorized like this. Right? We have solved this way. Now we have next way also. We could have also solved it from this one. Right? Circled one. So let me show you the next method of doing this. Okay? Can I rub this? Please raise your hand if I can rub this one. Thank you for your gesture. Right? So let me rub this again. Now, just keep patience. Okay? Because I'm holding my cell phone in my other hand. So it will take me some time to rub this one. This is very uncomfortable. Look at here. This is same question, but next method. Now it could be solved as cos cube theta whole square minus sine cube theta whole square. Even this is correct, right? So we can solve this as, look at here, it becomes a whole square minus b whole square, right? A square minus b square. The quantity that is inside the green circle will be a. This will be total a, right? And this total will be b. Now we can do the formula, right? Directly formula. It goes like this, a square minus b square, b square becomes a minus b, a plus b, right? So a minus b and a plus b look like this. Look at here, a minus b, it will be a, this is our a, and minus b, this is our b, this will be a minus b, and a plus b will look like this. See over here, a plus b, even this one is okay, right? You can further expand a cube minus b cube and a cube plus b cube form. Is it clear? But this one is already a factorized form. So leaving the question at this step won't create any problem. But if you want to solve it further, you can again break this into a cube minus b cube format and this one into a cube plus b cube format. Is it clear? But it is even wiser to leave it over here. Right? So this one is our next method. And I have stopped over here, right? I didn't go to the further expansion. This is clear, right? So let us move to the second question. This was our first question of factorize. Now let's move to the second one. Let's see the second question. The second question goes like this. Oh, it's better to write B, right? It was B. It says 3 tan square alpha, 3 tan square alpha plus 2 tan alpha plus 2 tan alpha minus 8. You are given this one to factorize. I'll repeat it to you. 3 tan square alpha, this symbol is called alpha. A-L-P-H-A alpha. Like this one. Alpha, right? It is Greek symbol. First Greek alphabet is alpha. It is small alpha and this will be our capital alpha. Looks like A, right? So it is the brother of A, nothing else. And this is 2 tan alpha minus 8. And I think this looks like this one. Look over here. 3x square plus 2x minus 8. Can you factorize this? Very easily, right? 8 threes are 24, right? And what are the factors of 24 which on subtracting will result 2? I think these are 6 and 4, right? Let me take you to the CMath first. This is 3. This is 8. Multiply this one first. 8 threes are 24. Right? Now you need such factors of 24 which on subtraction will result 2. So 6 fours are 24. Right? 12 twos are 24. 8 threes are 24. Now look over here. 8 minus 3 will be 5. 12 minus 2 will be 10. But 6 minus 4 will be 2. 6 minus 4 will be 2. And we here need 2 as our middle term. So we will now write this 2 as 6 minus 4. This method is called middle term breaking. Middle term breaking, right? Middle term breaking technique of factorization, right? And we are going to follow the same in our optional mathematics as well, right? So tan square alpha of here is replaced by x square over here. And tan alpha of here is replaced by x of here. And the rest of the numbers are same as it is. Is it clear? So let me do this. Or you can try it on your own. And if you are puzzled, then you can look at the board, right? Let me do this. Start doing, right? Start doing. Don't wait for me. You can try this on your own, right? Let me do this one. This will be 3 tan square alpha. And furthermore, it will be 6 minus 4 tan alpha minus 8. Is it clear? I have just changed this 2 into 6 minus 4. Middle term breaking, right? You have studied this in CMath. Now, we'll open the bracket over here. This will look like tan square alpha plus it will be 6 tan alpha minus 4 tan alpha minus 8. Is this clear? This tan alpha into 6 becomes 6 tan alpha. Tan alpha into 4 becomes 4 tan alpha. And the minus sign of middle is as it is. It is unchanged, right? Now, very good. Jayendra Dungana, You have already calculated. I'm happy for you. Keep it up. Right? This is not working properly. 3 tan alpha can be taken as common. Right? You know how to take common, right? So here will be tan alpha only. It is similar like taking 3x as common. Let me explain you first. In these two terms, I am taking 3 tan alpha as common. Right? So this will result to plus 2, right? Why? Because 3 tan alpha into alpha becomes 3 tan square alpha. And 3 into 2 becomes 6. So check your previous step as your cross-checking technique, right? And here is minus. So for these two terms, we can take only 4 as common. Only number is coming as common, right? So the next one will be tan alpha plus 2. Why plus 2? Because if you take a minus common from minus, it will be plus. Right? Is it clear? Is it clear? So these two are exactly the same. So we can write it only once. It will be tan alpha plus 2. Right? A repeated one or common factors can be written first. And the remaining ones are minus 4 and 3 tan alpha. So this will seem like this. Tan 3 tan alpha minus 4. Is it clear? So this one is the factorization of our question. Now let's move to the last question. Is it clear? Now be ready for the last question. We have only got 4 minutes left, right? And be also ready for your assignments. Right, la. And the next one will be simplify. Right, simplify. And we'll continue this in our next lecture as well, right? So here it is. For first one, sine 4 theta minus cos 4 theta. These four are powers, okay? And the denominator is sine square theta minus cos square theta. This is how the question looks. This is the question that carries about 2 marks, I guess. Sine 4 theta minus cos 4 theta upon sine square theta minus cos square theta. This is simplify. Is it clear? Now this is very simple. Look over here. Sine 4 theta means sine square theta whole squared, right? And this will be cos square theta whole squared. Is it clear? I'll do a bit faster, okay? Because time is running out. Cos square theta. Is it clear? 4 can be written as square and further squared, right? Now this will be a square minus b square. And it can be further written as sine square theta plus cos square theta, right? And sine square theta minus cos square theta. What did I do here? I have just used the formula. A square minus b square will result to a plus b and a minus b. Is it clear to everyone? And our denominator will be sine square theta minus cos square theta, right? And as far as I guess, these two can be cancelled. Right, as far as I guess, these two can be cancelled, right, because these are same. So the term that is left is now sine square theta plus cos square theta. This is left, right? This one is still remaining. And as far as I guess, this one exactly looks like a formula, right? Sine square plus cos square will result to 1. So this will be 1. Is it clear? Look over here. I have just expanded this into as a formula to sine 4 theta minus cos 4 theta, right? And 4 is written as e square and further whole squared. And a square minus b square will be a plus b and a minus b. And a minus b of here is cancelled by this one at the denominator. And the only remaining part from numerator is sine square theta plus cos square theta. And this will finally result to 1 because sine square theta plus cos square theta is 1. This is our formula. You can write it over here. As a side note, since sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. This is better to write as a side note. Is it clear? So this was our basic level factorization, product and simplification of trigonometry. Right? And by looking at these type of samples, you can solve all the exercise of first exercise. All the question of first exercise, right? and we'll straight move to the second one. Is it clear up to here? I think this one is clear. So if you have any doubt and confusions, you can ask me personally in the messenger or our messenger group as well, or in this chat as well, right? And this video will also be uploaded in YouTube, I guess. So you can answer the questions your query in the comment section, right? Is it clear up to this? So I guess now we should end our class. You can raise your questions if you have any. If you have any questions, you can raise it. And after some time, I'll post your assignment in your Google Classroom. Please look at that, right? And complete within the due date. It'll be beneficial to you.